All right, it is the big moment now to hand out the award. Please welcome Mr. Tami Makazi.
Good evening. The player of the tournament from Kaizer Chiefs is Arthur Batman.
Right now, to end the Telkom segment of our show, please welcome Mr. Jimmy Tao from Kaizer Chiefs to receive the Telkom Knockout Trophy on behalf of the champions, Kaizer Chiefs.
It's MTN8 Wafa Wafa time. The country's leading eight professional clubs from the 2008-2009 season went head-to-head for the earth-shattering 8 million rands winner-takes-all prize. Now, for a team to achieve this feat, winning 4 matches is all that is required. Let's relive the excitement of the MTN8.
The 2010 edition of the MTN 8 kicked off on the first week of August. With 8 million rand at stake and the defending champions in action on match day one, the race was on to see who would be the last team standing.
Thank you. of the MTNA. And Funk now in trouble, and then scores! Tom with a chance. Oh, it's an own goal! It comes off Ivanovs. Now it's a tight angle on goal, but he's going directly. Is that number six? Yes, it is! He has scored a remarkable finishing goal.
In the end, the last team standing would be Golden Arrows, Abafana Bestende scoring an avalanche of goals to confirm their championship status at the 2009-2010 WAFA WAFA tournament.
Wow, what a tournament. And to tell us more, MTN South Africa's general manager, that's brand and communications, Mr. Velima Bana.
Good evening. MTN's involvement in football goes back many years, with the company being passionate and committed to the development of sports across the continent. The MTN 8 has quickly become one of the most anticipated events on the local football calendar. And through our sponsorship of teams such as Ajax Cape Town, Golden Arrows and Black Leopards, we are showcasing our proud tradition of being involved in African soccer. While tonight's function is to recognize and reward the players and the technical staff for your performance throughout the past season, for MTN, the standout moment has to be the MTN 8 tournament. We were particularly proud to have had both our sponsor teams, Ajax Cape Town and Golden Arrows, make it through to the knockout stage to eventually contest the 8 million rand WAFA WAFA. Winner takes all, MTN 8 final held at Orlando Stadium in October last year. Attending the final all the way to Johannesburg under tough circumstances at the time was not easy on both the Ajax Cape Town and the Golden Arrows players or their supporters, who also traveled for hours to get to the venue. But not even the long journey could quell the anticipation of such an exciting final as they arrived at Orlando Stadium singing and dancing to support their teams. We congratulate Golden Arrows on being crowned the MTN 8 champions for 2009. Last year's MTN 8 tournament was truly a Nayoba experience. We also congratulate the winner of our MTN 8 Last Fan Standing competition, Mr. Tulani Ngobo, on winning what we believe is the most incredible football prize to attend the 38 FIFA World Cup matches next month. Tulani's prize will see him attempting to break a Guinness World Record for the most FIFA World Cup matches watched. And on that note, we are here tonight to celebrate the achievements of the stars of the season past. But for MTN, as the only African partner to the 2010 FIFA World Cup, we are also here to celebrate the 2010 FIFA World Cup, which is less than a month away. As the first African global sponsor of the World Cup, we have been working closely with all the parties involved to ensure that Africa hosts the most spectacular World Cup to date. So let us now celebrate the hard work, commitment and flair of our local players and teams tonight, and look forward to the festival of football that will descend on our shores in just a few short weeks. Ayoba South African football, thank you.
All right, the spirit of Ayobaness. Now, the MTN 8 Last Man Standing Award is awarded to the player who has exhibited consistency, high performance, passion, and something they call the can-do attitude. And also, fair play, desire, all in the spirit of WAFA WAFA.
Well, in normal terms, the player would be referred to as the player of the tournament. But in line with the MTN 8 theme, this award is called the Last Man Standing, with prize money of 150,000 rands. Let's take a look at all the nominees.
Jabulani Mangana, Lamontville Golden Arrows. Every coach loves a scoring midfielder in his team, and this is the role that Mangana excelled in during the MTN 8 competition this season.
Could this be the magical moment that brings 8 million to Lamontville, plus of course their first ever trophy?
He proved a tricky customer in all the matches, but his performance in the final at Orlando Stadium was awe-inspiring.
Mangana could get another here perhaps. Little chip. Oh, Mangana! Oh, he's found it from the tightest of angles! There is a chance of
Richard Enyekane, Lamontville Golden Arrows.
It's Richard Enyekane!
Golden Arrows' success has largely been linked to the scoring abilities of Enyekane. Instrumental in Arrows' progression this season, this feared striker did not disappoint with great performances in all his matches during the MTN 8 competition.
Face of Enyekane, finding the back of the net.
Dipsy Selulwane, Ajax Cape Town.
Scores!
Despite finishing on the losing side against Lamontville Golden Arrows in the final, the Ajax Cape Town midfielder had an exceptional tournament, scoring a series of crucial goals, including the winner against Orlando Pirates in the quarterfinals.
Second shot. And Malik Joseph going the one way, wrong footed.
But to reveal the winner and hand over the trophy from MTNSA, Mr. Veli Mabena.
Ladies and gentlemen, in a true Ayobane style, the MTNA Last Man Standing Award goes to Jabulo Mangana from Lamontville Golden Arrows.
Congratulations indeed. Now to end off our MTN segment, please welcome Umqeqeshi Mangoba Ngqithi to receive the MTNA trophy on behalf of the Wafa Wafa champions, Lamontville Golden Arrows.